Has your Google account been hacked? Here's what you need to do right now. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you find yourself in a situation where you believe that your Google account has been hacked, there are things you need to do to basically recover the account and fix it so that it doesn't happen again. I have to warn you, if your account has been hacked, and the hacker, or whomever, is sufficiently either motivated or just for whatever reason, it is possible that you may not be able to get your account back. I need to stress that because a lot of people panic. Rightfully so. Let's go through what you need to do if you find your account's been hacked. First off, this sounds really stupid, because it's so obvious. But step one is recover your account. In other words, log into your account. If you can't log into your account, take the steps associated to recover your account. Now, I get it that you may believe that you have been entering the correct password and it is not accepting your password. All that really means is there's a really good chance that somebody else has changed your password. So it's not your password anymore. You need to go through the steps that Google provides to recover the account. I'll have a link to my article, Lost Gmail Account Recovery with No Phone or Alternate Email, in the companion article for this video. But the bottom line here is that Google includes several recovery options, A, provided you set them up beforehand. And as long as you did, you may be able to regain control of the account. I need to stress, you need to follow those instructions carefully and completely. I hear from too many people that give up after the first option doesn't work. There are several things that Google may provide you with that will allow you to identify yourself as the rightful account holder. If after all that it fails, well, I'm sorry to say, if recovery doesn't work, it's not your account anymore. The hacker has successfully stolen it from you, and whatever method Google is requiring you to identify yourself as the rightful account holder has failed. It's not your account anymore. There is no customer support. There's nobody to talk to. If the automated services don't work, you're out of luck. It's not your account anymore. Go set up a new account and start over. Now, if you can sign in, absolutely change your password immediately. That is one of the things that hackers sometimes do. They'll leave your password alone to basically lengthen the amount of time before you might notice that there's something fishy going on. So, even if you are able to recover the account, or even if you're seeing that it's hacked for some other reason, or even if you just suspect that it's hacked, change your password right away. Then change or set all of your recovery information. In Google's case, that means things like alternate email addresses, phone numbers, I mean, other techniques that may allow you to recover the account. Those are the things that hackers will sometimes change. Make sure that everything in that list is something that is in your control. It's your email address to an alternate email account that you have access to. It is your phone number to a phone that you still have access to. If they're not yours, remove them immediately and make sure that the list of alternate recovery methods is all and only things that you can control. Overlooking this, getting even one of them wrong, leaving one of them that the hacker has set, means that the hacker, once they realize that you're back in your account, they can slide right in and hack it again. Don't let them do that. Make sure that all of the recovery information is yours. Now, it's controversial, but I actually suggest letting your contacts know. This is one of those things where we don't know what the hacker was doing while they were accessing your account. They may very well have been using it to send spam, but they may also have been using it to essentially impersonate you and try and trick your contacts into taking actions that you would never ask them to do. Usually it's a scam type scenario. Sometimes it's a phishing attempt. But the bottom line is that given that we don't know what the hacker was doing with your account, let your contacts know that your account has been hacked and that everything up until this message alerting them of the fact should be suspect and that they should not follow instructions therein. Finally, the last thing, and this is especially true if you did not get your account back, learn from the experience. I have a list. Use long passwords that can't be guessed. Use a password vault or password manager to safely store all of those different passwords. Don't share your passwords with anyone. Don't fall for phishing attempts. If they ask you for a password, they're bogus. Don't click links in email or in private messages or in text messages that you aren't 100% certain of as being legit. Many phishing attempts will lead you to bogus sites that then ask you to enter your user ID and password, when in fact what's really happening is you're handing them over to a hacker who then immediately signs into your account. If you're using Wi-Fi hotspots, learn to use them safely. Keep the operating system and other software on your machine as up-to-date as possible and make sure to run up-to-date anti-malware tools. Learn to use the internet safely. And consider enabling two-factor authentication where simply knowing the password, which is something that sometimes hackers can get, is not enough for them to sign in. Now, I've presented a list here. I've got links to articles that discuss each of those in more detail in the companion article for this video. Again, I have to reiterate, if you're having trouble getting into the account in the first place, make sure to follow Google's account recovery process as carefully and as completely as possible. Like I said, too many people give up too quickly. But if you do, if you follow it carefully and you follow it completely, and it still fails to regain access to your account, it's not your account anymore. And you need to start over and learn from the experience. I know that's not great news, but it's the news. For updates, for comments, for a lot of related links to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/162505. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.